Hi guys, thanks for joining me. Today's episode is a little different. Lately I've been doing everything from bed, from online shopping, binge watching TV, eating in bed. I have my breakfast tray that I use. I love to eat in bed and it's adjustable. So I can raise the back up so I'm sitting up straight. So we're gonna go over some of my purchases and some disappointments that I have as well. So let's get started. My snack of the day today is brought to you by, they're not really sponsored. It's just crap I like to eat. Is Häagen-Dazs. I found these minis. They're little mini ones, so you're not eating like a giant Häagen-Dazs. And they are so yummy. This one has like almonds and toffee. Oh my gosh, so good. So, wanna talk about a couple things. I had mentioned in the beginning, disappointments. Okay, so this is kind of a rant. Today, that I'm filming, was the release of Jeffree Star's cremated palette. And I went on and it put me in this loop to go to PayPal to pay. I literally sat there with this, well, first time the little circle was spinning, directing you to PayPal. And after about 20 minutes, I backed out of it. My order was still open. It still showed my palette and the lip gloss that I was gonna buy. So I hit PayPal again. Same thing, the little circle going round and round and round. I sat there for 40 minutes because I was afraid I was gonna lose it. Then it closed out, put me back in my cart. And both of my items in my cart were sold out, no longer available. Now I shouldn't complain because I've been pretty lucky with Jeffree Star's launches, but not today. I was really pissed. And then I got all emotional because, you know, I try to get like the hottest things to review on my YouTube channel so that y'all can see them before and make an educated decision if it's something that you want to buy. I appreciate it if you guys value my opinion. It means a lot to me. But yeah, I just started thinking of like all the videos that I've done, all the videos that I have praised, gave glowing reviews to Jeffree Star products. And I've always sent them a link. I DM him on Instagram to Jeffree Star and Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I always send a link. I always make a comment praying for his dogs, you know, wishing him well, wishing him success, commenting on his looks. And then any video that I review or mention, I send the link. Not once have I know. I know he's very busy. I know he has millions of followers, and But I got a little butt hurt. Not getting the palette kind of triggered it. But then I started thinking about all the videos, all the messages, all the links that I've sent him with nothing. And I just got really sad and I felt really kind of like, I don't know, unappreciated. And then I thought, you know, hire some IT people to fix your website. It always crashes. It is always redirected. People are always put in a queue. People were pissed on Twitter today. Get interns, too, to answer your fans when they send you DMs. I mean, I don't care if it's a generic pre-written letter that says, thank you for reaching out. Appreciate your support so much. Jeffree Star. And it could have like his signature. Just a generic letter, just something. There are interns that can work for almost free. And they would love to work for Jeffree Star. And they could handle your fan base and people who send you these letters and these links and these things. So that's my beef. I'm really fucking annoyed. I wanted that palette. And I'm still going to get it. It's probably my most favorite palette from what I've seen that's come out of his. It is just so beautiful. So, yes, I will get it. I had a bitch about it. If anybody watching Housewives, it's getting, oh my gosh, these ladies are insane. They are a little cray-cray. Yeah, I'm watching New York is on right now. Atlanta still has the third part of the reunion, which they're doing it all via internet, which is really cool. This is a weird new world we're living in. I mean, the masks and the social distancing and the people who are not wearing masks and not social distancing and just, it's crazy. I just can't wait till it gets back to normal. How about you? What else do I want to talk about? Something before I go into my haul. I had some other things I wanted to discuss. I know. Okay. So, two things. Wanted to remind you about the contest, which is getting ready to end. The month is almost over. So, my shout out is to Robin Bell. And she's referred me, I think, 5 new subs. And I wanted to thank her so much. You are a shoo-win. Is that a shoo? Shoo-win? Shoo-win. A sure-win? Sure-win? Anyways, Robin, you're probably going to get one of the Target gift certificates. I also want to thank Kimberly. I want to thank Maggie. You guys have been so wonderful and loyal. You guys are just awesome. And you guys are the ones that inspire me to keep on going, to keep on plugging away. And I will never, ever forget you guys for being there from the beginning and for supporting me. It means the world to me. Other thing, I'm doing my next video I'm filming. Hopefully I'll film it tomorrow. And then I have to edit and stuff. But I might be editing this all day tomorrow. You don't want to hear about all that crap. You're like, blah, 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 blah. Mrs. Snow. My cat Missy's here. And her hair's on my ice cream. Oh. So tomorrow, I'm filming a Q&A. All about interior design. If you don't know, I am a professional interior designer. I went to school for design, and I'd been designing over 20 years, predominantly residential. I do commercial from time to time. Oh, my Botox. Look. I can move my eyebrows. I can move my eyebrows and show expression. This is not good. I don't want any expression from here up. This shit needs to be frozen. So I'll be really happy when I can go get more Botox. And I need a little filler too, but I don't need it, but I want it. It makes me feel good about myself. But back to my point, I'm always rambling. I've gotten some amazing, awesome questions that I'm using all of them over on my Facebook. Yeah, so if you guys have any interior design questions, please put them below in the comments, and I'll be sure to answer them when I film that. So it should be fun. While I'm at it, please hit the thumbs up if you enjoy my videos. And please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Thank you. And also ring the little bell and hit all. And that will notify you whenever I've uploaded a new video. Oh my gosh, I've got like this pile of stuff I've got. Oh, I'm like, but I've got some good stuff. And almost everything I've got, no. Wasn't on sale. That wasn't on sale. That was on sale. Let's just get into it after I finish my ice cream bar. Okay, so the first purchase I want to talk about is this lamp. It's a giraffe lamp, and they made an original one, and I saw it on First Dibs, and it was it's life size, and it's holding a giant crystal chandelier, and I clicked on it, and it was $39,000. I was like, oh. And, but I loved it. And then I was on Instagram, and I saw this. It was like a little mini version of that giant life size lamp. And I clicked on it, and it was like way less. And so I splurged, and I got it.
This is the giraffe lamp. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. It's so cool. He's like holding a chandelier in his mouth. And he's quite tall, but I just love whimsical things, dramatic things, and I think he fits in perfectly.
Oh, don't you just love it? It is so cute. Okay, so let's get into stuff I've bought. Let's start off with Sephora. So I did a Sephora haul. They had their VIB sale going on. And so I wanted to get some of my tried and trues and a couple of new things. And what I got was, and then you won't believe what I did. I actually ordered the same things twice. Yeah. Because that's how my days are. So I ordered it, I think, in April. And then I ordered it in the beginning of May. And so now I have doubles of some things. And my cat will not shut up. The problem child. Go. I have to film. Okay, so what I got at Sephora was my favorite perfume was starting to run low, and that's by Yves Saint Laurent. It's the Mon Paris. It is a very, it's a light floral, but not like a rosy floral, more like I like a jasmine with vanilla. It is like, it's so yummy. So if you like those kind of scents, that you'll love Mon Paris. Then I got my favorite concealer in the whole world. This stuff, Nikki Tutorials talked about it first, and she said that it was her favorite concealer. And I thought, well, okay, she likes full coverage, so I'm going to try it. And I've been using it ever since. And it is the Jouer Essential High Coverage Liquid Concealer. And this is actually going to be my third bottle or tube. It's a tube. A tube. It's a tube. That's a weird word. I had points that I had. So I got these Focused Spot Dark Spot Micro Tip Patch by Dr. Jart. And they're little patches. And I thought, I have a couple sunspots on my forehead, so I'm going to try that out. And then I got the Beauty Blender Bounce Airbrush Liquid Whip Concealer. And this has been getting a lot of pretty good reviews. I've seen a couple mixed ones, but I'm going to try it out. So we'll have a first impressions coming up. I also got the Charlotte Tilbury eyeliner, eye color magic liner duo. And it's got two colors on it. And I can't even remember what the colors were. I was just excited about the VIB sale, and I'm rouge, so I get 20% off. Okay. Oh, one side is amethyst. That's right. I love amethyst. And the other side is like a vampire maroon color. And then I got the new, oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this. I said in another video, I thought it was the Laura Mercier, but it's mascara I wanted to get. It's not. It's the mascara I got is Anastasia of Beverly Hills, and this is called Lash Brag. And this has been getting a lot of really good reviews. So I'm always on the hunt. Okay, when I was at the grocery store, I picked up, oh no, at the pharmacy. So this wasn't an online purchase. This was just a purchase. I'm always in search of the perfect brow pencils, brow applicators. And so I tried out, this is a brand called Koki, spelled K-O-K-I-E. And I got it in ash blonde, which looks like a really light brown. I also got it in ash brown, which looks like a medium to almost dark brown. So I thought I could use the two of them together. So I'll do that with the Bounce concealer. And then I found a Revlon Colorstay Longwear Lip Liner in color nude. And you know my favorite lip liner I always talk about is Rimmel Addiction. So I thought, you know what, I need to find another lip liner because these people are going to be tired of hearing about Rimmel. Oh my gosh, she's talking about the Rimmel Addiction lip liner again. Yes, we got it. We got it the first five times you said it. Yeah, I got that. So maybe I'll be saying, I love Revlon. Revlon's my number one, my go-to. Oh, and I got Bambi Eye Mascara, and this is by L'Oreal. And so I'm going to try that out. And I got the Black Brown. So when I do my natural, like, stay at home or go to the store, just I don't want to do a lot of makeup. Which, by the way, I had to do my makeup today to go with my pajamas because we were doing the bed thing. So I'm kind of in bed with the glam look. Yes, that's normal. All right, let's move on. Oh, Nordstrom's. Anyways, they had some phenomenal sales, like really, really good sales. So I got this cute little gray wife beater, and this is by BP. Then I got this cute top by Topshop, and it is really interesting. It's got these really cool sleeves. I'll wear it in an upcoming video. And I don't know, it's just really cute. It's got a really deep V. It's got this kind of star pattern on it. Then I got a tube top, anticipating being able to have a life in, oh, this was only $12 for Nordstrom's. I mean, so it's like a little tube top for summer. And then I got these cute pants with this little print, and I love, they're very light, and they've got a little bell on them. And the pattern, I don't know what the pattern is on these. They're just random little shapes. There's no pat, there's no flower, there's no star, there's none. It's just a little blobs. Little psychological blob test. So you can look at, it's almost like, you know, when you had the ceiling, the old ceiling, and you'd look at the ceiling and you'd try to find like shapes in it. Or looking at clouds and trying to find the shapes. And you like try to tell your friend, look, there's the duck. The duck is right there. Look at, there's its bill. There's its head, its little neck going down. Look, it's a mallard. But, okay, now it's changing. So now, it's a flamingo now. Oh my gosh, it's a flamingo. It's a flamingo. Do you see it? Look, look, no, right there. So yeah, I got those. And then I got these cute jeans. Like, I needed another pair of jeans. But these are holy. And I think the model that was modeling these was petite. Because on her leg, this giant hole in these jeans, like, had her whole, like, knee and, like, 6 inches above and below her knee. Perfectly centered. On me, it's much higher. But it's still okay. But these are the jeans. Cute. And then the back just has a little nod. But this, yeah. So those are really cute. Okay, so I've also become kind of obsessed with the Real Real. But honestly, I don't go on there. I don't go on there for like really high-end brands. Yeah, no, I go for, I don't know, like Max Mara, Theory, Roberto Cavalli, brands like that, St. John, Missoni. So let me show you what I've got, what I purchased. So the first one, speaking of Missoni, and there, guys, there's actually some really good buys on there. I'm all about a bargain. So when I go on The Real Real, I'm looking for a deal. And with anything, almost everything, where are my glasses? Almost anything, you can do the code REAL and it'll give you 20% off like that. So this Missoni, what did I pay for you? $52. Now Missoni, this would normally be at least $500. So that's a steal. And it's so fabulous. It's like this navy blue with like almost like a chartreuse green. And it's just, it's so pretty. Very lightweight. Okay, what's this one? Oh, I love this one. And I keep getting things that I think, you know, oh, you know what? I could wear that when we can go out and have a normal life again. I didn't leave the little receipt in this. But again, I always look for a deal. This is Max Mara. And this was made in Italy. And this is like this really cool open hole, deep V, kind of metallic. How hot is that? Oh my gosh. I cannot wait to wear this. Maybe I'll wear it for my the interior design Q&A video. Oh, and by the way, I knew I was going to wear these pajamas. So, and I knew it was blue. And I thought, oh, I'm going to use blue, but blue blood. I was going to use the blue blood palette. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm going to give you a tongue twister. Okay, try this. The big black bug bit the big black bear, and the big black bear bled blood. Okay, now, it's so funny. Try this. Do it with your friends. Do it with your family, whoever you're quarantining with. If you're doing Zoom, have your friends do it. It's really funny. I can do it really good. The big black bug bit the big black bear, and the big black bear bled blood. The big black bug bit the big black bear, and the big black bear bled blood. So do it. It's really fun. Just remember, the bug bit the bear bled blood. So the big black bug bit the big black bear, and the big black bear bled blood. Oh, more real. Oh my gosh. Help me. This one just came today. I haven't even pulled it out of the thing. Okay, this top is Lafayette. And I got this for $40. Hello. Okay. And this is so freaking adorable. Look at the ruffles. Oh my gosh. I love this. Okay. Oh, and look at the size guide. Be sure to do that, because some of them are made in Italy, and so you want to see the conversion and what that size is, and also if it has the tag on it. Not the price tag, but the size tag on it, because sometimes they'll say, oh, well, the size tag's not on it, but based on the measurements, we guessed it was a large, and that will come. And honey, it's made for an Olsen twin. Okay, so then I did a Morphe. I think this was, yeah, this one I got at Ulta. Ulta? Or no, I got this at Morphe. This is, my whole point about my blue pajamas. I was going to wear the blue, but, oh, and then I went into the big black bug. Okay, now I remember what happened. I'm okay, really, I swear. So I was going to use the blue blood palette, and I was so pissed off today with the cremated palette that I was like, I am not wearing any Jeffree Star today. But prior to that, Morphe had a good sale, and I got the, I have his brushes already, but I don't think I knew that they had one that was just only eyeshadow brushes, and I love the pink, and it has this lovely little case, and they're pretty decent brushes. And then I got the mini lips. This is the Iconic Nudes. And it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I always saw the Jeffree Star Bullet minis, but I never saw ones that were like this mini. They're so cute. They're so little. Oh, here's the Max Mara sweater, the one with the holes. I spent, $72 for that. But Max Mara, that would probably be about $350, I'm guessing. So $72 And I don't get bugged out. Some people get really creeped out with secondhand clothes. I don't. I could give a rat's ass, you know, just dry clean it. Sometimes they don't even dry clean it. I smell it, and if it smells good, I'm good. Okay, I have a new obsession for the hair. Honey, I go through a lot of different shampoos, conditioners. I try the Function of Beauty, and it's actually not bad. It really isn't. But then, you know the Bum Bum cream? Well, that's by Sol Janeiro. Anyways, they came out with shampoo and conditioner. And I thought, you know what? I've got to get it just for the scent, the smell. And I'm going to pray that it's good. And I saw some bad reviews on it. But I didn't care because I love that smell. You know, the Bum Bum cream. Anyways, I got it. And I just, this is my second bottles that I'm going to be coming up on. It's good. The conditioner is good. The shampoo is good. The smell, you know how when you have a conditioner that smells really good and you rinse it out and it rinses the scent out. Honey, not this. The scent stays in your hair. So I can smell my hair and it smells like Bum Bum cream. The cream, the Bum Bum cream. Your hair smells like ass. Oh, I know what we can look at. Okay, this is a good one. Because, you know, they... let me see. Can I still sit Indian style? Is my body capable of that? I haven't exercised forever. I used to do yoga. Kundalini yoga was my favorite, but it was kind of weird and uncomfortable at times because the Kundalini yoga is all about breathing. It's all about positive energy. And then it's all about squeezing your groin and you're like, okay. But somehow it works with the breathing and the squeezing and the, I don't know, you leave Kundalini yoga in this like euphoric state. So yeah, if you have a chance, try Kundalini. Speaking of eroticism, no. I got this because I get the worst. I haven't been able to get a massage. And I have a masseuse that actually comes to the house. She's wonderful. And she's not doing massages now either because I was getting desperate. And I thought, well, maybe if we both wear a mask. Which, by the way, I saw this study. This is interesting for you all to know. But the study was, oh, and hello, stubby short nails. Yes, they're gone. But look, I did a pretty good job. I painted them. I put a little sparkle on them. I feel handicapped, though. I can't do anything because I've had acrylic nails forever. I'm struggling over here. I know I sound like a princess and you're like, shut the fuck up. Who's this bitch think she is? And I'm not making, I don't want to make light at all of the pandemic for the lives that have been lost, for the families of people that have passed. It's a horrible, horrible, awful, pandemic virus, and I'm doing bird calls now. What the hell was I saying? It started with the C. The coronavirus. Yeah. No, I was gonna say. I'm a comedian. I mean, so Not technically, but I did go to the Groundlings and audition. After my divorce, two of my girlfriends and I rented this fabulous, like old Hollywood style home. It was sick. And it was right off of Sunset and Doheny. And what the hell was the point I was making? I can't remember anything. My brain. This is my brain. And this is my brain on drugs. I can't. I'm going to have to edit some of this. I'm going to have to take that all out. I'm going to have to take all this out. Lindsay, don't be a bad influence on the youngins watching. And it's clogged. Okay. I don't know what the hell I was talking about. I was talking about the house. I was talking about my divorce. So one of my roommates is an actress. I love Sarah. Hi, Sarah, if you're watching, I love you. You better be, bitch. You better subscribe to me. You never leave a comment. I wonder. That's not right. Anyway, Sarah was in the Groundlings, and she said, you should audition because we'd have dinner parties. We'd have a ton of people, and I'd love to mix, you know, like an attorney and an actor and a stockbroker and I don't know. I just like to mix people and have drinks and have dinner, and it was fabulous. It had a separate dining room, and it had doors that shut the dining room off so that you could hire someone to cook or serve and bring the dishes out. So it was lovely. We had great dinner parties. Anyways, I would make people laugh so hard they would like pee literally their pants. And she said, Lindsay, you should try out for the Groundlings. And I thought, you know, that might be fun. That might be a good outlet. So I went thinking of it purely as just like an outlet. And I got in. I passed. And then every semester, they advance you or they don't. And they would turn down a lot of people. I mean, a lot. And they would be like crying. I just kept getting moved up. Keep on going. Keep on moving. They like me. So I think I'm funny. You know, sometimes I can make people laugh. I hope I make you guys laugh. So I got a vibrator. A giant, giant vibrator. No, it's for my shoulders and it's for my back. I did, you know, of course I tried, but and yeah, it works. So it has all these different attachments, and we'll take that attachment off. Now you've all seen this. This has been on Instagram. Okay, so you put it on. It's cordless. You just charge it, and then it's got an adjustment. Oh. And it needs to. I thought it needed to be charged. That was frightening. Yeah, it's the one. You know, they show it in slow motion, and they show the skin like, like rippling. That one. It's called the Pure Wave. And it's actually really good. This was $100. And it's got all these different attachments. It's got this one with like little spikies. That's more. And it's got this one that you can use with like lotion, with like massage oil. And then I don't know what this is for. I haven't figured it out. I need to read the directions because that's just weird. Anyway, so it's good. It's really good. And I love that it's cordless and it comes with the charger. So, I think I'm really happy with that purchase. And then it's got this nice little bag that you can put it in. So that was my other splurgy thing besides the lamp. Hair before today's release of Cremated. I'm so pissed. I got on Jeffree Star's website. And don't tell me this is not. See, I don't have my nails anymore. I can't do this. I need a knife. Oh, there. How cool is that? Oh, it's so pretty. This is my first time seeing it. Pulling it out of the box. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, it's so shiny. Yeah, this is a fun look, but I don't know if I'll be doing this again. I don't like the hair in my face. I like to be able to just grab my hair and like swish it around. And I can't do that with all these pins in my head. If you watch The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, the new girl, or no, I'm sorry, New York. The new girl, Leah, I kind of dig her, but I have a feeling that she's a hot mess and there's a reason why she stopped drinking. Because based on the tiki torches and then the coming attractions for the next episode. Woo! I don't know. But she had her hair parted in the center, and then she had two like berets or clips or whatever, like here and here, and it was like, and I thought, okay, I'm gonna try that. Here's a handy little tip. So I like to have chocolates in bed. I find it decadent, and I just love having chocolate in bed. Now, honey, I ran out of the good stuff, so I'm on Hershey's and Reese's Big Cup. Oh, Kinder Bueno, these are really good. Anyways, so they were on my nightstand, or they were in a bag next to my nightstand, and I thought, you know what, I want to have my snacks close on the nightstand, but I don't want to see them. So go when Home Goods opens up again, or Marshall's, just get one of these nice little glass boxes, and you can put your snacks in there. And that way, when you're craving a snack, you just get in, get your snack, and it's pretty on your nightstand. So there's my design tip of the day. Oh, the drawing. So guys, refer your friend, your sister, your aunt, and have them subscribe, leave a comment that you referred them, and I'll be giving away the $200 gift certificates to Target at the end of the month. So that's that. Thank you guys. It was fun hanging out, and I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Don't forget to, if you have any interior design questions, it doesn't matter what it is, leave it in the comments and I will include it in my Q&A coming up. And again, thank you guys so much for your support. I love you guys so much, and I want you all to have a wonderful morning, afternoon, or evening, whatever time it is that you're watching. Mwah. Bye guys. Okay, so this is a guilty pleasure. This is a hobby that I was really, really into the hobby, like, I'd say 6 years ago. And I collect these dolls, and they're called Blythe. This is a custom African-American one. But I just love them. They've got big heads, little bodies, and people customize them. I customized several of them, but I just love them. They were originally from 1972, And they were only around, I think, for 1 or 2 years because children found them creepy because of the big eyes. But there was something fascinating and special about them. And much later in the early 2000s, I think, there was a photographer, Gina Guerin, and she photographed them, and then different designers, they did a book, and all of these big, big designers, Gucci, Prada, Armani, Sonia Rykiel, they all styled a Blythe doll. So there was a toy company in Japan, and they got together and they started reissuing them. And I think they started reissuing them in 2001. I think that was the first one. But anyways, they're called Blythe. And I have my little African-American, I have my little black Blythe. Again, she was customized. Blythe discriminates. They don't make black Blythes. So I had to have, and you know what? Honey, she's being responsible. She is wearing her mask. Yes, she is. So they're really cool. They have different eye colors. They have strings in the back of their head. So you pull it down, that's her eyes closed. And then you open them and you've got another angle and another color. These are her blue eyes. And I guess I should take her mask off so you could see her face. She's been tested. She's good. Anyways, I just think they're adorable. I haven't been actively in the hobby, although I have lots of friends that are. I love seeing their pictures. I used to do photography of them, like professional photography. And I was really pretty popular in the Blythe community when I was active. Anyway, she's so beautiful. I just love her. And I bought some dresses for her. Oh, and by the way, the mask is by Little Ditzies. It is absolutely, look at how tiny and cute that is. That I've gotten it since obviously we've been in quarantine. It's a mask. So I got this little dress by Rosie Galuti, Kimberly. And look at how pretty that is and delicate. I mean, there are these people that hand sew, machine sew, hand stitch, applique, and make the most amazing little things. And then this is Maker and Muse. And this is an adorable 60s glam jumpsuit. Hello. Yeah, I made her like kind of military, but chic with the little shoes, but with like the army green because, you know, she's got her mask on. She's out there. She's doing the Hunger Games. She's going to the store. I'm gonna play with my doll. It's nice because there's a saying, never lose your childhood innocence. And that's what this doll does. It's like it brings my childhood innocence out. It's very therapeutic. Look at how adorable. Now, you have to admit that is pretty. And if you think she's creepy, that's okay. I've heard it a lot of times. If it's not your thing. I'm going to put on her 60s jumpsuit. How cute. Look at. Oh, and by the way, I named her Naomi after Naomi Campbell. I have a Naomi Campbell story. I'll tell you another time. So that's Blythe. I love her. All right, so that's it, guys. This is how I feel. Help me. Help me. I love these little, they're called Fugglers. Fugglers. They're so cute. They're little monster dolls with teeth. They have little teeth. Okay, so now I've shown you two things that potentially could creep you out, or maybe you're just going, I need that. I want one of those too.